love will win. In our hearts there will be peace, and our souls will float on home again. Float home again. Float home again. Float home again.
Hello, lovely people. Today I would like to share with you some of my daily thoughts, and today would be about healthy ego and unhealthy ego. And I would like to again try to commit, or commit, because trying is not enough. I would like to commit to give almost every day or every time when I have some inspiration or something to share, to make commitment to share it on the daily basis, on the daily basis. Yes, it's the second or maybe third time when I do this commitment. So it's the person who needs a bit of inspiration. Sometimes this kind of works, especially they are a little bit challenging, you know, like it's showing off myself to the others, showing my imperfections, showing the imperfections of this video. So it's everything a little bit of challenge, you know, like if I will wait for the perfections to happen, then, you know, like I will get nervous throughout my life. Basically, through imperfections of these videos, I would like to teach you, share with you, that not everything has to be perfect to be useful, you know? Like even maybe I cannot create a perfect video, maybe my English is not so perfect, but there is value with this, what I'm sharing sometimes. So go beyond this perfection. Also, when you create things, go beyond the perfection. A lot of people, especially women, I see that they make beautiful art, whatever art it is. Maybe they write a book, maybe they create some movie, maybe they make some drawing or whatever. And you know what? It happens very often. They end up in the draw because they are never perfect enough to be said, okay, they are finished. And you know, like, it's pity, because so beautiful value is on these pages, on this art, and it ends up just because we are conditioned that to perform, to get the best grades in the schools, you know, like to be always good enough, perfect enough. But yes, so I would like to talk today a bit about, you know, about our healthy ego, about our unhealthy ego. So first of all, you know, like the ego concept, it's a part of us which basically take care for ourselves, yes? And I recognize unhealthy ego and healthy ego. Unhealthy ego, it's a the ego was I take care for myself, but I don't care about anyone else. It's like when I have targets, I will go there and over dead bodies. No, like so. Yes, unhealthy ego is thinking just me, and doesn't matter about the others. As far as I'm good, doesn't matter. If I make profit on the wars, it's me who is most important, and that the other people are dying and killed, doesn't matter. It's important that me. So this is the unhealthy ego, when you are selfish. Healthy ego, I recognize as a loving yourself. And recognizing in this love to yourself, that as more I love myself, then there is too much love, what I can give to myself, and from this abundance of love, I can share love with the others. I recognize that there is there are the others. And also, when I share something with the others, it nourish my healthy ego. My healthy ego feels like, yes, wow, good, that's nice, you know, like, and that's what I'm asking you, a bit of encouragement, you know, like, I'm sharing that with you, like, the things what I feel valuable, what I would like to support the humanity with. And yes, my healthy ego is asking for a bit of encouragement from you. Like, yes, I like what you say. Yes, it helped me. You know, if I hear something like this, my healthy ego is like, yes, yes, you know, someone is happy about it. They love energy circulate between. You know, like, it's beauty. Then, you know, like, this is the healthy ego. So, I would like to continue a bit about the ego and unhealthy ego and things like this. So in many even spiritual teachings, we have to kill our ego, we have to kill our mind. In Tantra, we recognize the healthy ego, healthy mind, as our best friend. And if they are not healthy, the Tantra purpose is to heal, to transform unhealthy ego into healthy ego. Unhealthy mind, what is like monkey mind jumping from one place to another, into the healthy mind. The mind, what is here and now, what is in the present, what it's not affected by some conditionings, some wounds what happened to us, but it's out of the source, like how it is. The mind would see things how they are, not how unhealthy mind is projecting it to you. Yes? So, yes, there are many projections. We are conditioned by the situations, by the circumstances, by our parents and so on. And you know, like unhealthy mind, this unhealth, that's these conditions what we are living up to. And the purpose of life is to get to know yourself, to see what it really means. Is it the condition? Did I choose this protection? Did I choose that condition? Or maybe it's my parents put it on me? Or maybe the society where I live put it on me? But actually, it's just putting me in the cage to obey how they like. Maybe it's not me. Maybe I like to be naked, for example. Maybe I like to think when I drive on the bicycle. It's nothing wrong. So all these things, you know, like you have to recognize. And I would like to give gratitude in this video to the book, what I really think is the most powerful book ever, I would say, for me. It's Conversations with God. It's so even that there is a few times mentioned the Tantra word, and there are a lot of beautiful things about sexuality written. What I completely agree, it's like written from my heart. I really relate to that book. But the book is not tantric, so for me to say about not tantric book that this is more powerful book even than Margot Anand, The Path to Sexual Ecstasy, what I feel is tantric Bible, it's even this book what bless the teachings, bless the experience what I got with them. Still, even you can compare the powerfulness of the book. So it, I really recommend, by the way, both books. Okay. So keep pointing out, like, hey, you know, like society, religions, parents, teachers, all the stuff what is conditioning us, they are putting in our heads ideas what are actually not ours. For example, to don't like sex, to be ashamed about sex, to not to talk about sex, to that the sex is something what you have to do in hiding yourself. You know, like most of us consider in deep of our hearts sexuality as a beautiful thing, as a beautiful moment, beautiful expression of love. That's what it's supposed to be. Nothing to be shameful about it. If we should be proud that we love someone so much and we share sexuality with that person. Somehow, we should be ashamed about it. Another thing what also a lot in spirituality, it's about, you know, like that the money is bad. Money is a tool. It's a, you know, when I have more money, I can create better circumstances to my students to learn. I can create leaflets, I can spread to the people to share the wisdom of Tantra, that they know, oh, there is something else in the universe, yes? Thank you, money. I can help other people, you know, like I can pay my employers a very good wage and make them happy, make their family happy, you know, make my family happy. So, yes, I love money. You know, I need to, please give more, then I can use it in the best possible way for me, you know, like we anyway spend a lot of money in the taxes for, you know, wars and whatever. So, you know, like, I would say better give it to me. I would spend it on love to the humanity. Yes, so yes, it's nothing wrong with money. It's a tool. It's how we use the tool. And if the tool doesn't take over us, that's the point, you know, because when the tool, like the money, it's taking over us, then we are greedy, then we are forget that it's supposed to be only tool, then we become a slave of money. So we have to recognize, like, with healthy ego, unhealthy ego, healthy money, unhealthy money, yes? You can say dirty money or, you know, good money, you know, you made it in the good way, you know, with your hard work, with you even did a lot of good things, share beautiful wisdom and so on. There is also another conditioning with Neil Donald Walsh is mentioning in his book that people should not receive the money for the spirituality. You know? I'm sorry, it's bullshit, you know, like, we like to live, you know, like the life, what it's supporting you in the best way. If I don't have money, if I have to go to work and do other things, what maybe they are not so beneficial, like sharing my wisdom, then we lose all of them. So yes, it's very good to support the people who are giving us the most valuable things. With the money, appreciate their work, what they do. And unfortunately, we are living in the conditions that most of the precious, beautiful works on that planet is not well paid. Like teachers, nurses, doctors, mothers. I could go on like this and on. So yes, there are other things, you know, like for example, to not to like, yes, we are conditioned to not to like the compliments, you know, when to be humble. But it's different to be humble and to be appreciating someone's compliment, you know, like, and letting it nourish your healthy ego, you know, like, when someone is saying to me, oh yes, you did good job, And very often we are conditioned to say like, oh no, it's nothing, forget about it, nothing special, you know? Hello? Someone is telling us, hey, you did good job, I appreciate. And you are saying that it's nothing? So how this will nourish you, nourish your self-esteem? How this will encourage you to give of that more, you know, what some other people appreciate? How this will encourage the other person to say again thank you, or maybe do something for you and to let this energy flow, circulate? So yes, so that's what I wanted to talk about, the conditionings. So, and yes, the cue for it, it's as always, I'm preaching this mantra all the time. Love yourself, love yourself, love yourself, and see the truth beyond the lies. Liberate yourself from the conditionings, what circumstances put it on us. Time to wake up, awaken. Thank you for listening. Yeah, love.